Hi, and welcome to Med for Care. Today's topic is amenorrhea, or absence of menstruation. Let's find out together what it is. The term amenorrhea means a particular medical condition characterized by the absence of menstruation, which occurs in the fertile life of a woman. Amenorrhea can occur transiently during pregnancy or last over time as a result of other causes of a pathological nature. Excluding pregnancy, we can speak of pathological amenorrhea when the absence of the menstrual cycle lasts for at least 6 months. Amenorrhea occurs physiologically during pregnancy and during breastfeeding, but in some women, it can also persist throughout their fertile life. In the second case, the estimated incidence is 1% of the general population. It is also useful to underline that from an epidemiological point of view, no particular differences were found in the appearance of amenorrhea in women belonging to different ethnic groups. Amenorrhea disorder is classified into primary and secondary amenorrhea. The first type consists in the absence of menstruation already from puberty, without having ever had the first menstruation, called menarche. Primary, amenorrhea must be taken into consideration when the menarche does not come in the 5 years following the development of the breast button or if the patient is already over 15 years of age. In secondary amenorrhea, on the other hand, there is the presence of a lack of menstruation for a period of at least 6 months from the last menstrual cycle. The causes that lead to the absence of menstruation must be distinguished in primary and secondary amenorrhea. At the base of the first type, there can be anatomical defects, high concentrations of FSH, or disorders of the hypothalamus, polycystic ovary syndrome. Turning to the causes of secondary amenorrhea, the most common physiological factors are identified in pregnancy, breastfeeding, and menopause. If these physiological causes are then excluded, secondary amenorrhea may be caused in part of some of the elements attributable to primary amenorrhea. First, hormonal dysfunctions or pituitary tumors can contribute to the onset of amenorrhea, even in a woman who has had a regular menstrual cycle. Weight loss, chronic anovulation, and ovarian tumors are then counted among the other triggering causes. The calibrated balance of several hormones, which intervene in specific ways in different anatomical areas, physiologically triggers the menstrual cycle. In detail, the hypothalamus initiates the hormonal cascade, setting free the releasing hormone of gonadotropins, which acts on the pituitary gland for the secretion of two important hormones, follicle-stimulating hormone, FSH, and luteinizing hormone, LH. The action of the two hormones then intervenes in the endometrium to promote the production of other steroid hormones, such as estrogen and progesterone, responsible for all the changes that occurred during the menstrual cycle. Any pathological modification along this whole axis of hormonal signaling can therefore easily lead to an alteration of the ovarian cycle and amenorrhea. The gynecological specialist visit is the essential tool for an initial evaluation of a patient with amenorrhea. The visit to the gynecologist begins with a thorough medical history of the patient, asking the patient's age and whether she ever menstruated during puberty. The physical examination, on the other hand, focuses on the overall evaluation of the patient and on the detection of her anthropometric indices, including the measurement of height, weight, and the estimated fat mass index. If hyperandrogenism syndrome is suspected, the skin should also be carefully inspected for signs of hirsutism, acne, or hair loss. Subsequently, the doctor inspects not only the patient's genitals but also her secondary sexual characteristics such as the breast, noting the state of development of the breast button. The evaluation of this disorder is carried out on the basis of instrumental or laboratory tests such as dosage of some hormones such as prolactin, FSH and LH, dosage of beta-HCG to rule out pregnancy, which is the most common condition of secondary amenorrhea, pelvic ultrasound to identify any masses or anatomical defects, karyotype analysis to evaluate the patient's chromosomal structure, excluding important syndromes such as Turner syndrome. The management of a patient with no menstrual cycle depends on the specific cause that led to the amenorrhea. Several congenital anomalies are at the origin of primary amenorrhea. In these cases, it is possible to proceed surgically by deleting a possible short vagina or by incising an imperforate hymen. If the absence of menstruation is instead determined by hormonal deficiencies, such as estrogen deficiency, it is possible to administer estrogen or set up an adequate nutrition program in case of malnutrition. On the other hand, when there is a polycystic ovary syndrome, it is used as a therapy based on oral contraceptives associated with metformin. In those cases where the absence of menstruation derives from intense emotional states or anxiety disorders, cognitive behavioral therapy associated with antidepressant drugs is usually recommended. Among the best prevention strategies, we find the administration of calcium and vitamin D to patients with amenorrhea, since these people are at the higher risk of contracting bone fractures. We are now at the end of this video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you found it useful, please support us with a nice like and subscribe to the channel. See you soon in Med4Care!